Blackstone Publishing presents Utterly Wicked, Hexes, Curses, and Other Unsavory Notions by Dorothy Morrison. This book is read by Liisa, Ivary. All charts, diagrams, and photographs that appear in the print edition of this book can be found in the bonus PDF file that accompanies your audiobook CD or download. For Jonathan Minton, who on more occasions than I can count has kept me safe and sane, and who on more occasions than he'll ever know has saved a good portion of the world from becoming green, warty, and ribbity. In memory of Ken Valu, who would have been just as excited about this book as I am, and Velvet Reet, who witnessed the worst of my cursing, both magical and otherwise, and still loved me in spite of it. I miss you both. And in memory of all those folks who once called me Whitesy Lightsy, they should have known better. Foreword. You, dear reader, are holding a treasure. A treasure by a woman who is not only an incredible writer, but one who has been bringing her humor and utterly fabulous brand of witchcraft to us for decades. I have adored Dorothy Morrison's books since the late 90s, but my connection to this one is particularly special. In the summer of 2007, I was working at a shop called Mystical Voyage, teaching classes on topics ranging from folk magic to herbal spellcraft and reading tarot for clients. I was thrilled to hear that Dorothy would be publishing another book. Reading the promotional material for Utterly Wicked, I was eagerly anticipating its release and started mentioning it to others in the shop. You see, in late 2005, after the devastation of Hurricane Katrina, Dorothy, among other prominent pagans, got together to auction off items with the proceeds going to Hurricane Katrina charities. I was the winning bidder of a one-of-a-kind piece, A Book of Shadows by the lovely Dorothy Morrison. This beautiful book arrived at my home as a ream of printed parchment with the title page autographed by the author. I was thrilled to have not only materials from other books I enjoyed, but unreleased materials as well. I hoped that some of the unreleased material would appear in Utterly Wicked. When Ms. Morrison later appeared at Mystical Voyage on tour for this book, I made sure to bring the massive Book of Shadows with me to thank her again. Dorothy was the first person I thought of when seeking endorsements for my first book, Blackthorn's Botanical Magic. She was also the first to respond. Dorothy doesn't just understand the practices laid out in these pages. She writes from a deep well of knowledge and practice. At Mystical Voyage, we had adjourned outside during her break between tarot clients to catch up and trade stories about mutual friends, while Ms. Morrison had a cigarette, which, when she finished, she snuffed and put back into the pack with a knowing wink. "Taglocks," she said. "Never can be too careful," I replied. "We are aware of the problems that can arise from leaving DNA from hair, or saliva on a cigarette butt, or a used napkin accessible to others. Policing these items is one of the smartest things a magical practitioner can do." That is one of my favorite parts of Utterly Wicked. Not only does it stretch our ideas about curses, hexing a lousy habit, using a puppet to nurse yourself back to health, but it helps us protect ourselves against hexes by knowing the methods employed to lay them. Don't leave your hairbrush with hair in it. Get your possessions back from exes, both friends and lovers. This book is recommended reading for everyone. It helps break curses and hexes as well as lay them. It helps the reader learn to spot charlatans and provides the tools to combat fear, hatred, and malice. Utterly Wicked also supplies user guides for dirts, from the graveyard to the courthouse and everything in between, washes, powders, and more. Whether you like making healing waters or collecting dirt from various travels, or if you enjoy wandering cemeteries, or want to dress an 11-inch fashion doll because you hate sewing, this book is for you. Since I began practicing magic as a young lady, I'd like to feel I'll always look at it with fresh eyes. It was easy for people to dismiss my experiences at 18 when I joined my first adult coven. That's how I knew my first high priestess wasn't the right fit. Every sentence she spoke to me sounded as if she were patting me on the head. The first person to treat me as a potential magician of worth was a hoodoo practitioner who said that I was starting to become who I was going to be and that I had to act like it. Dorothy understands your worth, reader. She's here to show you how to step into being the practitioner you know you are going to be. Remember, magic is agency. Magic is the ability to stand up for yourself when enough is enough. It is the voice in your gut that says, you don't have to take this. Whether it's gossiping coworkers or a boss who thinks sexual harassment is a benefit of the position, you can change things for the better. Not only do you deserve to be protected and cherished, but you are making things better and safer for the ones who come after you. It may be scary or complicated, but I have faith in you, and so does Dorothy. Amy Blackthorn, owner of Blackthorn Hoodoo Blends, author of Blackthorn's Botanical Magic and Sacred Smoke. Introduction. Wicked witches, evil sorcerers, things that go bump in the night. Whether through fairy tales, nursery rhymes, or the occasional movie, these become a part of our lives long before we can walk or talk. They shape our innermost fears, have the ability to cause cold sweats, and reduce us to little more than a pair of shaking knees. Even so, they form an important and productive part of who we are, for by their very introductions into our lives, they also force us to plant those first seeds of courage, fertilize them into worthwhile battle tools, and bring them to harvest with the need to stand up for ourselves, our rights, and our beliefs. They are the very things that make us capable of screaming bullshit at the top of our lungs and simply refusing to take the crap anymore. Not that any of it's easy or quickly forthcoming. It takes time. So much time, in fact, that we usually ingest a lot of crap before refusing another helping. But eventually, we're done. We look at the plates in front of us, the ones still heaped with all of that ghastly mess, and consider our options. And with the garbage can overflowing and nowhere else to toss that stuff.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.